This Python code calculates the factorial of a number you give. It runs fine, no errors are given by the interpreter, but the output is wrong. We have a function that loops from 1 to the given number and multiplies the values, saving the result in the result variable. When calculating the factorial of 5, I get 24 as the result, which is incorrect cause the correct answer is 120. Same goes for any other numbers, our logic is correct but the result is incorrect. So let's try to debug this code to find out what went wrong.
How do I do that?
If you don't have any idea on debugging, then don't worry. When I started coding, I did not know about debugging either. So take a deep breath and stay with me till the end and you will be able to debug anything that you want. A famous Canadian computer scientist, Brian Kernighan, quoted that debugging is twice as hard as writing the code in the first place. Therefore, if you write the code as cleverly as possible, you are by definition not smart enough to debug it. Well, you may be smart enough to debug your code, but do you really do that? Or do you keep coding and coding and then start scratching your head when something goes wrong? Or do you just feed the code to an AI to find out what is wrong? Well, feeding the code to an AI can be efficient in some cases, but debugging is a very important skill that every programmer should know. Because first of all, it saves a tons of time. When something goes wrong in your code, instead of scratching your head or asking help from your senior, you can simply debug your code to find out the issues. It can also improve your logic building and problem solving skills. So, what is debugging? Debug, which means we will be removing bugs. Debugging is the process of finding errors and bugs in our code and then fixing them. According to me, there are three levels of debugging. Most of us are in the level 1, that is, knowing or unknowingly, we have all debugged our code, like removing common errors of missing parentheses, semicolons, etc. All this comes in level 1 of debugging. Now, the people who use print statements to debug the code are in level 2. And I still use print statements a lot to find and fix errors in my code. Yes, we can use print statements to debug the code. For example, in our factorial code, if we add print statement to see the value of I and result on each loop, we find that I goes from 1 to 4 when our number is 5. No matter what number I pass, the value of I is always 1 less than the given number. This means we have a problem in the range function. The range is always 1 less than the given number. Did you notice it when you saw the code for the first time? Let me know. So, the range function in Python takes two arguments, start and stop value. If your start value is 1 and stop value is 10, we see numbers from 1 to 9 because when range function encounters 10, it stops there without including 10. So, to fix this issue, we can adjust the range to n plus 1. And now our code should work perfectly fine.
Yes, it works.
And congrats, you have successfully debugged a code using print statements. Now on to the level 3 of debugging, in which we use debugging tools instead of print statements. When the code gets more complex and complex, print statements can be of no use, and that is when modern debugging tools are useful. In modern code editors such as VS Code or any others, there is always an inbuilt debugger. In VS Code, by clicking before the line number, I can add these little red dots. These are called breakpoints. To remove them, I have to click on it again. Now, breakpoints are the points where debugger will pause the execution of our program so that we can examine our program. After adding breakpoints, simply click Run and Debug to start debugging. As you can see, the program is paused at the line 4 and the current value of these variables are displayed here. By clicking on this Continue button, I can resume the program until it comes to the same line again and gets paused. Now, after the first loop, the result is still 1 and I is at 2. By clicking on Continue button, we can keep observing the values and try to find out the error. Once the error is found, close the debugger, fix the code, and hooray, you have learned to debug code. Now, can you tell me what these three buttons do when we are debugging our code?